So a very good morning, students. So today we are going to discuss on the topic of culture and seed production of cobia. Probably you might know the scientific name of cobia is Rhachisentron canadum. Rhachisentron canadum.
Spelling sir, cobia. C-O-B-I-A wala sir, cobia.
हाँ cobia. Cobia is the cobia जो है वो common नाम है. और Rhachisentron canadum जो है, Rhachisentron canadum is the scientific name of cobia. And it belongs to the family Rhachisentridae. So Rhachisentron canadum is the single species of the genus Rhachisentron and single family of Rhachisentridae. ठीक है. So we will start from the slides. So I am just going to share the slides with all of you. Okay. So prior to enter into the topic, so we will see a little bit historical background of the species. It was the first journal aquaculture research that has reported in 1975 with the collection of wild cowed cobia eggs off the coast of North Carolina, USA. And in 97, the technology to raise large quantities of cobia fry that had been developed. And the first reported captive spawning of cobia was achieved or succeeded in 1996 in Mississippi in USA. So later on, there were various development with the time, but between 2000 in India, it was the 2010 when Mandapam Regional Center of CMFRI, Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute, that get success in the broodstock development of cobia, and later on they have also pursued success in the broodstock development as well as the seed production of this species. So prior to knowing about this species, we must know about the distribution and the habitat of the species. The first thing is that cobia are pelagic and are normally solitary. They are normally solitary, but except for annual spawning aggregations occur for some time. They used to be congregate at reefs, wrecks, harbors, buoys, or any other structural oases. Oases means some favorable field grounds where they can spawn well. So they may also enter into estuaries and mangroves in search of prey, because they are predators. They are found in warm temperate to tropical waters of the West and East Atlantic throughout the Caribbean and in the Indo-Pacific region of India, Australia, and Japan as well. So you can see in this map where the red zonation in this picture, the red zonation depicts the distribution pattern of the species. So you just see the Indo-Pacific region and the Caribbean region where the distribution of the species occurs, as well in the North American and South American continental region. So what is the biology? So they are able to tolerate a wide range of temperature, and they can sustain from 2 to 32 degrees Celsius. And they can tolerate a salinity range between 5 to 44.0 ppt. What I am telling about that, they can tolerate it. But what they prefer is the warm water more than 20 degrees Celsius. And they have typically have annual migratory patterns. So they spawn various times, many times, from April to September, with peak in July month. Then this attains sexual maturity in males in 1 to 2 years, and in case of females, the maturity attains from 2 to 3 years. So females grow larger as it does most of the fishes. So females grow larger and faster, with maximum sizes up to 60 kilogram. Spawning occurs in both near shore and offshore waters. So probably you might know that what is the difference between inshore and offshore water according to
depth.
According to depth, yes. So where females release 1,000 to 1,000,000 eggs, and the size of the egg is 1.4 millimeter in diameter, which are then fertilized by the males. What does it mean? It means that fertilization takes externally. Then the viable eggs begin development. They are heavily pigmented, they are buoyant or floating in nature, and hatch in approximately 24 hours. The larvae of cobia, they grow rapidly and is large in comparison to most of the marine species. Juvenile fish are found in both inshore and offshore waters, especially among weed lines, where they seek shelter from predators and can feed. Then they are very opportunistic feeders, and examinations of the stomach contents have revealed that they feed on various items like fish, shrimp, squid, and particularly they like crabs. So now we come onto the sexual dimorphism. So there is no pronounced sexual dimorphism as it occurs in case of carps or in other species. But sexual maturity is reported in males in 1 to 2 years, and in females 2 to 3 years, as we have just right now discussed. Females grow faster and larger with maximum size of 60 kilograms. So what is the production cycle? So if we see the production cycle, you just look at onto your mobile screen. So the brood stock, after the selection of a brood, means how can we select the brood stock? The cobia, the female cobia of 2 to 3 years old, they are reared in ponds or tanks with egg collectors for spawning. So they are reared up to 10 kg. Okay. After that, the male and female segregation, once they are reared, the brood stock, after the injection of or induced for the purpose of induced breeding, after the induction by the injection of hormones, they are kept together, and once fertilized, once the egg fertilization occurs, then the fertilized eggs are placed in nursery tanks or ponds, where they hatch within 24 to 30 hours. If optimum temperature maintained. Then one can observe a heavily pigmented egg of size about 1.2 to 1.3 millimeter. Juveniles are typically graded for every 4 to 7 days, and it reaches almost around 30 gram after day post hatch of 75, and they reach up to a length of 19 millimeters. So after that, these larvae placed into the grow out in ponds or near sword cages from 30 gram to 100 or 600 gram, depending on the operation for stocking, they are kept. Once they got a size of 100 to 600 gram from 30 gram, 30 gram तक हम लोग क्या किए, इसको हम लोग ने ग्रेडिंग किया 4 to 7 days तक, और जब 75 दिन के बाद जब ये 30 ग्राम के हो गए, हम लोगों ने इसको नियर शोर जो केजेज हम लोगों ने इंस्टॉल किए थे यहाँ पे हम लोग इसको स्टॉक करते हैं. आफ्टर दैट व्हेन दे अटेन ऑलमोस्ट 100 टू 600 ग्राम्स और ऑफ अ लेंथ अराउंड 180 मिलीमीटर, आफ्टर दैट these juveniles are transferred to open ocean cages for the final grow out around 6 to 10 kg, and within 8 to 12 months or within a year they can attain a size of 10 kilogram. Got? So how much fast they can grow we can see. So what is the stages of cobia culture? So here you can see the brood stock rearing, where a female of 2 to 3 years old and a male of 1 to 2 years old is being kept together. They are conditioned well. After the induction, after the inducing agent, after the induction by a particular inducing agent, they are kept together, where spawning, where breeding and spawning takes place, and after spawning the egg is the eggs are collected to hatchery production unit, and after that nursery and rearing unit, after the hatchery production unit it is transferred into the nursery and rearing unit, and after when they attain up to a size of 30 gram, then they are being transferred into a grow out pond, where they are being cultured up to 100 to 600 gram, and after a particular period they are transferred into open ocean cages, where they can grow up to 10 kilogram within a 1 to 2 years. Okay, so how brood stock management we can do? Brood stock management usually includes collection, selection and domestication of brooders, as well as control of maturation, spawning and egg collection. So this is the main principle behind this brood stock management, because they are found in wild condition in Indo-Pacific region nearby India. If we talk about Indian continent, then brood stock development is mostly practiced in sea cages in order to ensure good water exchange and healthy environment. Brood fishes can be stocked at a density of about 2 kg per meter cube. Brood fishes can be stocked at a density of about 2 kg per meter cube. Now you just calculate, if a brooder of 10 kg size, then how much meter cube space will be required? I hope you can calculate it very well. Then the trace fish like sardines, cats, etc. are fed once in a day at the rate of 5% of biomass or till satiation. Satiation means till they satisfy, till the feed demand becomes negligible or ignored. The trace fish has to be supplemented with vitamins and hufa like fish oil, squid, liver oil. I hope all of you are knowing hufa and hufa. Then broodstock nutrition is very much important, and there is positive correlation between hufa and in the broodstock diets and in the eggs and larvae. Not only in case of cobia, but various brooders, they require hufa and hufa within their diets. So they must be supplemented at a required dose. Then bigger fishes of 10 to 15 kg weight having normal shape without any deformity and with healthy behavior, because they are juvenile and are they are selected as broodstock. The other important criteria for broodstock include bright coloration and the anus, that is very easily recognizable. Best temperature for maturation is around 27 degrees Celsius. Although they can tolerate a wide range of temperature from 2 to 44 degrees Celsius. And the best salinity range is 30 to 34 ppt. Okay. So separation of males and females from the broodstock cage is required for conditioning the fish for breeding. Cannulation can be done. So for the assessment or for the selection of brooders, so prior the selection of brooders, cannulation can be done to check the maturity of female and the maturation of the maturation of male is also can be checked by gently pressing the belly when milk oozes out. In case of female where the cannulation is being done, if the egg size is larger than 0.7 mm, it must be non-adhesive in nature, then it should have a white color and a round shape. Because the eggs are floating in nature, so while the assessment of the mature female brooder, we must have to take or consider these points prior to selection of brooders. So usually two males and one female are introduced to the spawning tank. Natural spawning also can be obtained if brooders are selected. Hello. Yes.
Sir, cannulation मतलब क्या होता है?
Good. Cannulation मतलब क्या होता है कि when we use cannulation, एक हम लोग क्या करते हैं, पाइप लेते हैं, ठीक है? एक छोटी सी पाइप जो उसके genital pore में हम enter करते हैं और वहां से हम लोग little bit amount में हम लोग एक ड्रॉप एक जो है वो निकालते हैं. जनरली हम लोग के कार्प केस में देखते हैं, हम लोग जस्ट बेली पोर्शन प्रेस करेंगे तो मिल्ट जो होता है, चूंकि लिक्विड होता है, ठीक है, तो इट्स वेरी इजी टू ऊज आउट. मिल्ट ऊजेज आउट, इट्स वेरी इजी ऊजिंग आउट, ऊजिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ अ मिल्ट. बट व्हेन वी कम इनटू अ एग, एग क्या होता है कि वो राउंड शेप में होता है, सो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट. तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं, कैन्युलेशन प्रोसेस करते हैं. कैन्युलेशन में हम लोग सिंपली एक पाइप जो होता है ना, पाइप से हम मतलब एक छोटी सी एक पतली नली होती है, हम लोग देखेंगे आगे में कैन्युलेशन प्रोसेस भी दिया हुआ है कि कैसे एक छोटी सी पाइप लेकर के हम लोग क्या करते हैं, थोड़ा सा ओपन करते हैं उस जंक्शन को, जेनाइटल पोर्स को, तो वो जो आपके मतलब एग्स होते हैं वो बाहर आते हैं और हम लोग उसके थ्रू, क्योंकि जनरली ये कैन्युलेशन प्रोसेस अदर फिश के साथ हम लोग नहीं करते, बिकॉज दिस फिश इज वेरी सोफिस्टिकेटेड, क्योंकि हम लोगों को इसको एडप्टेशन करवाना और फिर ब्रीडिंग लेना ये बहुत टिपिकल है, इसलिए सेग्रीगेशन और ब्रूडर के लिए हम लोग कैन्युलेशन में जाते हैं. Then induction of spawning can be done by injecting LHRHA. LHRHA, what is LHRHA? LHRHA means luteinizing hormone releasing hormone analog, and it is being taken at the rate of 20 microgram per kg for females. So if a female is about 10 kg, you just calculate the required dose for the induction. Then 10 microgram per kg for females, spawning occurs within 12 to 24 hours after the injection. Once the injection is being done, the spawning occurs within 12 to 24 hours. Egg collection can be done manually from the tank by employing 500 micrometer net. So 500 micron, a pore size of 500 micron. So of that kind of net we can use for the egg collection. Then we come to the broodstock development and captive breeding. That is being done at a particular place in Mandapam. Here, the wild collected cobia brood fish, hooks and line commercial catches in hatchery. The fishes was treated first with 100 ppm formalin. Generally, they used to do. So prior to taking this project or doing this project from our hand, we must know how they process all these things. So they wash it with 100 ppm formalin for 2 to 5 minutes. Then they used to condition both male and females, both male and females, for 2 to 3 days in 10 FRP tanks before transferring to cages. So FRP tank should have a capacity of 10 ton at least. Then these fishes were fed twice daily at the rate of 5% body mass or body weight. Then with sardines and other fish species like pelona and ilisa, all of you are knowing that, and occasionally with squids and porcinid crabs, they fed vitamins also twice a week. Then the sex war separation sex used to be done by using flexible catheter. Jate ho by august ko dekh use karte ho koi catheter wo catheter hi hum log pati sipai hui hai jo ke genital pore mein dal karke hum log just usse open करते हैं. Then cages after the females were completed 2 cm of intra-ovarian eggs. मतलब क्या है कि हर 15 दिन में एक ऐसे लूप करते हैं कि जो डेवलपमेंट अब तक तब तक क्या रिक्वायर्ड एक नहीं हो जाए ना जो 7 एमएम डी सी वो वाइट कलर क्या ये सब कुछ हम लोग देखते हैं. कोबिया कैन्युलेशन सी तो कोबिया इन सी के तो इन गाइड हैचिंग ऑफ ब्रूड स्टॉक फिश फ्रॉम जो कि रिकॉर्ड को इन डालते हैं डालने के पास कोई क्लियर है यही ब्रूड स्टॉक पे रखे जाते हैं एडप्टेशन के लिए जो कंडीशनिंग करने जा रहा है ट्रीटमेंट पर आप ट्रीटमेंट क्या है उसको स्पॉनिंग पे ये सब फ्लोटिंग वाटर में रहते हैं तो हम लोग पतले साइज का होता कैथेटर तो उसके थ्रू हम लोग सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट भी सकता है. बायोप्सी मतलब एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ और जैसे कैंसर के लिए जनरली हम लोग यूज करते हैं. क्या होता है लोग कोई भी बड़ी कोई फ्लूड हम लोग से ड्रेन करने के बाद उसका एनालिसिस करते हैं बीइंग एग्जामिनर ऑफ बॉडी फ्लूड. ठीक है बीइंग नहीं करते एक्सीटू करते हैं बाहर से बायोप्सी करते हैं. लिविंग एग्जामिनेशन टिश्यू इज बायोप्सी. बायोप्सी कैन बी डिवाइडेड टू नेक्रोसिस एंड ऑटोप्सी. ऑटोप्सी क्या लिविंग एग्जामिनर ऑफ डेड टिश्यू नेक्रोसिस. देन आगे हम लोग देखते हैं फिर. तो इंड्यूस्ड स्पॉनिंग कैसे हम लोग करते हैं. स्पॉनिंग कैन बी ऑब्टेन आइदर नेचुरली और विद हार्मोन बीइंग पॉजिटिव एसआईओ ऑलिंग द एट 500 आई आई यू नेचुरली पर केजी बॉडी 250 पर गिव इट इज फॉर द 36 आवर्स आफ्टर द इंजेक्शन. द नंबर ऑफ 2.4 टू 2.8 एच कैन बी मैन्युअली एम्प्लॉयड बी राइट नाउ. देन फर्टिलाइज एग वेट 2 टन की मस्ट हैव रेक्टेंगुलर और सर्कुलर डेंसिटी. हाउ मच स्टॉकिंग डेंसिटी मस्ट बी 100 एग्स पर लेयर. This 20 position, as we have discussed that 27 more than 20 degree Celsius is the probable temperature for these ovums, and the optimum temperature 8% is being found 80%. This is measured up to 2.1. Then fertilized eggs of cobia collected from spawning tank. Hello. fertilizers of cobia platforms can use variety of the land seed production used to be done that cobia and are pelagic with single ovule which only as a day okay means at hatch then metamorphosis starts from 9 to 11 day post hatch metamorphosis means
रुको ना कहाँ जाना है नींद आ रहा है करे नींद आ रहा है रुको ना पांच मिनट तो जाना कहीं
हाँ हेलो
यस सर
हाँ 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 ओके सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड लार्वी कल्चर एंड सीड प्रोडक्शन इजंट इट ओके So cobia eggs are pelagic with single oil globule, which is resolved completely at 7 day post hatch. Then larvae mouth opens at 2 to 3 day post hatch. It is very much temperature dependent. Not this fish, but all the fishes are very much temperature dependent for the development of or for their metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is the complete development of a larvae into an adult fish or a well developed fish, where the organs are being completely developed. So it takes 9 to 11 day post hatch. Then After 10 day post hatch, they are fed by the green water technique so that the cost of production can be minimized. Then, after 18 day post hatch, they are fed on the artificial larval diets, and continuous water exchange is being necessary. Then, formulated feed also can be fed after 18 day post hatch. After 25 day post hatch, they are graded into several sizes and they complete it. So if you have any question, this slide, anyone can ask.
Sir, being sir, the
artificial larval diet, I mean, formulated feed has been fed 30 minutes before feeding. Weaning matlab bolna. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
अरे यार ये बहुत क्यों अचानक ऐसा होता है? किसी के हाथ में कोई ये इसका इसका कंट्रोल तो नहीं है?
No, sir.
कभी कभी स्लाइड्स पे कुछ ऐसा लगता है क्वेश्चन लगता है यहाँ आई डोंट नो हमको समझना पड़ेगा
नहीं सर
ठीक है ये बोल रहे थे वीनिंग टू आर्टिफिशियल लार्वल डाइट्स व्हाइल वीनिंग फॉर्मुलेटेड फीड्स हैज टू बी फेड 30 मिनट्स बिफोर फीडिंग वीनिंग मतलब क्या हो गया मतलब हम लोग जब
चुराना
फीड